Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the press conference to organized by UTM. Today we'd like to share our very important initiative, how to make a low carbon like a city level. So I'd like to introduce Prof Ho, and then also from University Technology Malaysia, and then Dato Ismail from Iskandar Malaysia region, and then Dato Hashim, Putrajaya Corporation, he is a mayor, and then Dato Omairi, he is a vice mayor of the Putrajaya. So I'd like to ask Professor Ho to brief our results, our message to the COP21.
Thank you very much, Dr. Fujino. I'm Ho Chin Siong from University of Technology Malaysia. And today we would like to share with you our Malaysian experience. How do we go about to reduce CO2 emission at the city level as well as regional development corridor level? So today, together with us, we have presidents from both local authorities or regional authorities. Of course, with us is Dato' Ismail from Iskandar Malaysia, development authorities, and of course, Dato' Asim from the Putrajaya Corporation. And what the Malaysian approach to this climate change and city level, we are using so-called S2A, science to action, whereby the universities, together with researchers, working with policy makers to come up with a very objective decision using modeling, which we work closely with NIES, Japan, and Kyoto University, to come up with a baseline study and also some scenario, trying to understand what is the business as usual as well as countermeasure scenario. And in order to assist local authorities making better decision and policy option, this model would able to provide alternative policy solution whereby we can identify what are the possible projects to be implemented by these authorities. So I will not explain the detail of this, but basically we still emphasize very much on triple baseline in terms of social, economic, and of course environment. And our emphasis is very much more on the co-benefit. How do we go about, apart from CO2 reduction, but we are emphasizing on a better quality of life, a better equity, as well as economic growth. And the other methodology that we approach here very strongly is we are using PDCA cycle. So to ensure not only policy making kind of document, but we also come up with a kind of monitoring to ensure that the implementation project would able to achieve its objective and continuous monitoring through inventory system. So I think this is basically our approach that the university have worked very closely with two local authorities. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Prof. Ho. Also, I'd like to invite Dato Ismail. He is the chief executive of Iskandar Regional Development Authority. And now, he like to announce his initiative to COP21, how to make low carbon cities from Malaysia.
Thank you. Iskandar Malaysia is actually an economic region that started almost 10 years ago. And this region, which is situated south of Peninsula Malaysia, has been experiencing rapid growth of an unprecedented kind in a region of about 7 to 8%. So with this rapid economic growth, we find that it is important for us to ensure that while we continue to consume energy rapidly whilst we experience growth, we must also at the same time ensure that this energy are being consumed on an effective and efficient manner. Hence, the embracement of the low carbon society project that started 5 years ago with the assistance of Japan, namely from JICA and from University of Kyoto, among others, as well as the local partners like University Technology Malaysia. And way back in 2012, we launched our first blueprint at COP19, where from this particular blueprint, we were able to cascade it down further at the implementation level at the local authorities. There are five local authorities within the region of Iskandar, Malaysia, and today we've been able to launch the implementation program for each of the five local authorities. And we're happy to note that after this, we will be putting a lot of work on each of the five local authorities to have the low-carbon project blueprint implemented at those respective local authorities.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Dato' Ismail, for your very strong message. And then next, I'd like to invite Dato' Hashim. He is the president of Putrajaya Corporation. Dato'.
Thank you, Dr. Fujino. Myself, Hashim, and Dato' Omari comes from Putrajaya, which is the new administrative center of Malaysia. We've been doing the projects together with University Technology in Malaysia, Kyoto University, National Institute of Environmental Studies, Tokyo Metropolitan Government, and Mizuho Information and Research Institute for the low carbon emission program of Putrajaya. And we are also proud to announce that today we are launching one program that we call Towards Putrajaya Green City 2025, particularly on the monitoring of carbon emissions by the building sectors. Other than that, Putrajaya is also embarking on the program for transportation system, low emission of carbon by the transportation system, and that will come later after the building sector. Yes, thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, so then shall we?
We will. Do the launching.
Yeah. So this moment, it is a very important moment for Putrajaya City, and I think it is also for all of us on the global scale. So Putrajaya now launched this brochure, this initiative, how to have the Green City 2025. So this is launching timing, and then please join our launching ceremony. Thank you very much.
We will
start
to launch.
And also, we'd like to share another very important material from Iskandar, Malaysia. And this is the blueprint from the five local authorities in Iskandar Malaysian region. So this is also our message to the COP21 parties. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay. And then, I forget to introduce myself, but I'm Junichi Fujino from National Institute for Environmental Studies. I'm a senior researcher. I work together with the Malaysian or Vietnam, Cambodia, or many Asian countries to have a low carbon society planning and also implementation now. Our team, AIM Asia Pacific Integrated Modeling Team, support Iskandar Malaysian region and also Putrajaya City together with the Japanese central government, JICA, JST, and the local government. And today, from my side, I'd like to share another good initiative. This is a CASPI initiative. Okay, this is CASPI. The Japanese initiative to having the a city assessment tool. We call it CASPI for cities values. And this is also the very important tool to the support Iskandar Malaysian region. So we may just launching. Oh yes. this is also for, yeah, how to support. And then we have INDC, so how to support also city level too. Yeah, thank you very much. And another introduction, I also joined like civil society. There is another message from the civil society. Just a moment. Eco Capital Creation Network, and then she had a proposal on a social proposal to the request for sincere host toward climate change on the occasion of 21st Conference of Parties, COP21 of United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. And this is a group of the local government in Japan. Roughly 20 local governments joined this one, and also researchers, including me, and also NGOs. So now, local government, and then researchers, and then NGO network, of course, central government, it's a time to work together. So I also would like to share this proposal.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, thank you very much. So, yeah, now I'd like to open this session, and then if there is any questions or comments from floor, I'm very much happy to have. Yeah.
15 minutes.
Yes. Or anything further comments from the panelists?
Yeah, I think this is a case where we Malaysians have started this low carbon initiative. Actually, started from 2009 when our prime minister promised or made a pledge on 40% reduction, and from there we universities together with local authorities get together and trying to do a baseline study. Or we're using quantitative modeling to understand what is the current scenario and what is the business as usual scenario as well as the countermeasure scenario. So this approach actually provides us a very important way forward to assist especially policymakers to come up with more objective decision in terms of urban development projects. Whether it could be solid waste management, transportation, energy system, or even planning of recreational and green area. And then, in fact, the two cities here, Putrajaya and Iskandar, Malaysia, has proven to be a very successful case study for Malaysian government. How do we handle urban management as well as CO2 reduction. So what we are trying to do here is, apart from not only carrying out this case study for Malaysian cities alone, we are also sharing it with our ASEAN neighbor. So we have been doing a lot of capacity building together with Cambodia, Vietnam, Thailand, Indonesia, and possibly Myanmar and Laos in this year to come. So this is a kind of ASEAN initiative, and we are doing not only policy making now, but we are now moving into implementation. So I think, as mentioned just now, you can see that Putrajaya especially, they have already gone into a kind of a building reporting system. We are taking care of CO2 reduction from the building sector, that is one. And in future, we are moving into transportation sector, yeah. Energy sector, mm-hmm. And of course, we'll cover all the other urban sector in order to achieve the most optimum CO2 reduction for cities. So it is going to be a kind of ASEAN model, not only doing it for Malaysian cities, but of course it's for ASEAN as well. Yeah.
If I may add. The Low Carbon Society project for Iskandar Malaysia, I think it's one good example where, as echoed by my colleague, not only about policy, but to ensure that this policy is to be implemented on the ground. Although Iskandar Malaysia is perhaps only one of thousands of projects that have been undertaken around this planet, but we feel very strongly that this is our way of contributing towards climate change as well as for energy efficiency and effectiveness. So this is a very important contribution on our part, and we hope with the experience learned and the from all this will be able to be learned by all, especially within Malaysia itself. Now, that is one part of what I'm trying to say here. Mm-hmm. Now, secondly, more importantly, is also this is an example whereby a project that is not only carried through by the government agencies, but more importantly, involving our two more important stakeholders, that is the community, mm-hmm. As well as the private sector. Mm-hmm. Bear in mind that when we talk about low carbon, a lot of the contributor towards the environment and its degradation is perhaps from the various industrial project that is been taking place all around, especially in the case of Iskandar Malaysia, where we are experiencing rapid growth. Therefore, the involvement of the three stakeholders, the public sector, that is the government, and the way in which the government needs to implement it, and of course, the awareness and the understanding of the people, and the way in which how people will be able to embrace this whole concept of low carbon, and equally important, from the private sector, on how as they proceed to expand their business activity, how they can also contribute in their way of making sure that we are living in a better world for the future.
Yeah, thank you, Dato' Ismail. Maybe Dato' Hasim?
Just to add on to the what Professor already said just now. The target, the national target is 40%. For Putrajaya, we target that 60%. Hopefully we can achieve that because as a whole, Putrajaya is a new city and it is a well-planned city. And one of the terms that we impose on the building plan for those who would like to build their buildings in Putrajaya is to be certificated as green building. And we have already achieved now, some of them having achieved platinum, two buildings have achieved platinum status, one gold and one silver. And under construction now we have 11 gold, one silver and one certified. Hopefully the whole building sector will take up the initiative to achieve that 60% target.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hashim. Yeah. Okay, any comment or message or questions, comments from floor? Okay, very clear. Okay. Thank you very much for joining this press conference. And then, this is very important momentum for not only for this negotiation, but also for these actions on the ground. Yeah. So thank you very much for joining us. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.